Christmas be chased. Tanya Harding, a disgrace. Online shopping, Amazon. Pablo Escobar is gone. Glove don't fit, you must acquit. Toy Story is a hit. Bush gore recount, hanging chats galore.
Spice Girls wanna be Dolly Cole, mad cow disease. Tim McVeigh, million men. Craven Slim is in the can. Titanic hits number one. Hong Kong, broken my Diana dies. MP3, Ellen comes out on TV.
We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. We didn't start the fire. No, we didn't light it, but we tried to fight it.
Home Alone, Happy Land, Gorbachev, Scissor Hands, Berlin Wall, and Russia Falls, Hubble Telescope. Rodney King, Rugrats, Anita Hill, Warsaw Pact, Death of Freddie Mercury, Beauty and the Beast.
Kurt Cobain, grunge rock, Hurricane, Lizzie Shaw, Mortal Kombat, finish him, Governor Bill Clinton, Johnny Carson says goodbye, Bill Nye, the science guy, Waco, Texas, Randall Hill, Clinton says don't ask, don't tell.
We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world's been turning. We didn't start the fire. No, we didn't light it, but we tried to fight it.
Smash Brothers, Let's Go, Jim Carrey, Truman Show, Malcolm Shepard, Torment, impeaching the president, Y2K, Columbine, Preacher says end of time, SpongeBob, SquarePants, Armstrong wins the Tour de France.
X-Men, PS2, Texas 7 on the loose, Chavo's case, Seuss's Grinch, Microsoft is in a pitch, 9-11 at the scare, Tyler Bendis everywhere, Houston flood, Yankees game, Harry Potter movie came.
We didn't start the fire, it was always burning when the world was turning. We didn't start the fire, no we didn't light it, but we tried to fight it.
Lilo Stitch, Spider-Man, War in Afghanistan, Ice Age, Idol, Riri wins the title, Columbia goes up in flames, but just playing war games, MySpace launches, Tom is my only friend.
Putin's notorious, Red Sox are victorious, Katrina blows us all away, what else do I have to say?
We didn't start the fire, it was always burning since the world's been turning. We didn't start the fire. We didn't
like
it, but we tried to find it.
YouTube hits, Pluto's gone, iPhone says Obama's on, swine flu, MJ's death, first black Disney princess.
Instagram, Kim Jong-un, Minecraft, and Laden, Zoom the Mayans, say the world is gone. Boston Terror Marathon, Malaysia 1370, gays can marry legally, Hamilton, Trump wins, hashtag #B2Begin.
Long as to be quarantined, COVID freaking 19, TikTok trends, BLM, when will all the chaos end? We didn't start the fire, California's burning, how's the world so turning? We didn't start the fire, but when COVID's gone, will the mask stay on and on?
Of the monomyth. So in STAC, every year we have a few independent projects where we go off and everyone does their own thing. They can choose their discipline and they can choose what methods they want to work with. And it's honestly the best part of STAC because you walk in and people are painting in the corner and then there's another corner where people are singing and songwriting. And this was the first solo project that I did that was in climate. Well, all of the projects have a prompt, so everybody works from the same prompt, but in the discipline of their choosing. This painting represents a challenge that I faced in my life recently, and I felt very vulnerable during that time. And it's really interesting to me to look back on it now, because this was a glimpse into how I was feeling at the time. And as much as I enjoyed making this painting, I don't feel like that anymore. Yeah, the painting might have had something to do with that. I've always used art, especially in STAC, to express myself. It's always been cathartic for me. I've usually gone to songwriting for that, but now I've done a painting, and it was a really valuable experience. Being able to work in multiple disciplines, especially disciplines that I'm not familiar with, it allows me to constantly have something new and something slightly scary in my work. And for this painting, I sought mentorship from other stackies who were better at painting than me or more experienced. That's the thing that I love the most about the arts and stack, is that I can never say that I've done it all.
For my solo project, we were assigned to create something that represented our ancestry, and I made a fake green card Visa lottery ticket, which, you know, they don't come in lottery ticket form, but I decided that the best medium to portray it, because in reality, the green card lottery is just a bunch of numbers going through a computer, but I think it would be cooler and more efficient to see it in person and have a visual medium to be able to see the numbers and the chances of being able to come to the United States through a visa lottery. My grandfather, he went back to Indonesia to be able to do a visa lottery, and he was able to win, and he was able to go to work in the United States and then later bring the rest of my family with him. And that's how my father was able to get a full citizenship in the United States. I calculated the probability of winning a visa lottery, which was, I think, like 0.001%, and then I put it into a random number generator to see if, like, oh, maybe if I rolled it a couple times again, maybe I would have won, but, you know, of course, I didn't win any of them. Something I think about, that the numbers, the probability of him being fortunate enough to have a grandfather who not only was born in Indonesia, but was able to take the lottery and then also win, was, it's such a substantially low number that if, like, anything different happened, I probably would not have been born, nor was my father able to meet my mother, and all of these line of events happening, which led to me being able to live such a fortunate life here with all these people in STAC. So I reflect on it a lot, and the numbers and how lucky I am to be here.
I don't really know too much about my grandparents, because it's kind of hard to talk to them about these things, especially since, like, all of them actually grew up in Taiwan in World War II, and so, like, some of the things that they experienced were also kind of hard for them to talk about now. And then there are some that just don't remember it at all. One, I guess, concrete story that I heard from my grandparents, it comes from my mom's side, her grandma. During World War II, Japan raided Taiwan. There was an air raid in 1945, and so she had to hide in the mountains, in the bunkers, and they had a lot of snakes and stuff, and then there was also constant, like, gunfire and bombing, like, just bomb sounds, and so she kept getting scared, and she learned this coping technique from her father, which she later, I guess, passed down to me when I was little. So it's centered around that, yeah.
あなたは俺が俺の恐怖にどう対処するか知っていますか？今から教えますのでよく聞いてください。恐れをすべて取り、それらをボルに砕き、準備ができたら暖かく微笑んで捨てます。
It's here!
What's here?
The letter!
What letter?
My college decision!
Oh my god!
Oh my god, I can't believe it's here. But are you gonna open it? What are you gonna do? I don't know what is. Oh my god, are you gonna open it? Open it now. I wanna see.
She is going to study law and I'm so proud of
her. Come on! Quiet!
Wait! Don't you guys think that the college admission process is like deeply dehumanizing? It has unfairly favors the wealthy and saddles students with an ever-increasing amount of debt.
Hi, my name is Audrey. The STAC art project that we worked on was this collaboration with the orchestra, the Herricks orchestra, and we had to listen to different songs and make art pieces that would be in the background during their show. Wrote the music that the orchestra is performing or did perform. He wrote the songs based off of a friend of his who was an artist that passed away. So he made these musical pieces to kind of pay homage to his artwork. Ms. Zebrowski had us listen to the songs and work with them to put together artwork in our own style, in our own mediums, to kind of go along with the music. My song was The Gnome. It was very, I guess I could kind of say bouncy in a way. And it was very, I guess gnome-like. Is that a word to describe? Yeah. I chose to use wires because it was something that was found in one of the art rooms. And I was like, okay, well, why don't I try it? So then that's what I did. And then the gnome with a pom-pom. I actually had some help with this. I know Lily made the pom-poms. And Aris did a lot to help me take the pictures for the actual slideshow. Ms. Zebrowski, well, I mean, she's a great person. So, I mean, like, she's very free-spirited, and that really shows with the assignments that she gives us. And she's very helpful. When we have a question, she always knows the answer on how to, like, make our work shine. You know, how to make it unique and personal to us.
Thank you.
Yeah, we memorized our lines really quickly. Super easy.
Line?
Oh my god!
It was really easy. Yeah.
Can't believe out of all people, Mira got Helena. She doesn't even have the perfect hair. She's not even tall enough.
We interpreted our script. We ran lines with each other. It was really such a productive environment for all of us.
We worked on this so hard and we're gonna win. We're gonna win first place. We're gonna win first place.
I read the emails. It wasn't a competition. There's no first place. Freshman.
There's no defining qualities that would make her Helena. You know who has the defining qualities? You wanna know? Me!
Leo's not tall enough.
I'm 6'5".
He's 5'11".
What's my line?
Again?
We've been at this for 5 hours!
Flower of this purple dye, hit with Cupid's archery, sink in, apple of his eye. When his love he doth espy, let her shine as gloriously as the Venus of the sky. When thou wakest, if she be by, beg of her for remedy.
Why should you think that I should woo in scorn? How can these things in me seem scorned to you, bearing the badge of faith to prove them true?
These vows are Hermia's. Will you give her over? Weigh oath with oath and you will nothing weigh. Your vows to her and me, put in two scales, will even weigh, and both as light as tails.
I had no judgment when to her I swore.
Nor none in my mind. Can you give her over?
Demetrius loves her, and he loves not you.
Helena, goddess, nymph, perfect, divine, to what my love shall I compare thine eye? Crystal is mighty, how ripe and show, thy lips those kissing cherries tempting grow.
Oh, spite, oh, hell, I see you're all bent to set against me for your merriment. If you were civil and knew courtesy, you would not do me thus much injury. Can you not hate me as I know you do? Will you must join in souls to mock me too? If you were men as men you are in show, you would not use a gentle lady so, to vow, swear, and super praise my parts, when I'm sure you hate me with your hearts. You both are rivals and love Hermia, and both rivals to mock Helena. A trim exploits a manly enterprise, to conjure tears up in a poor maid's eyes. With your derision, none of noble sort, would so offend a virgin and extort a poor soul's patience, all to make you sport.
Hi, I'm Alex Tunney, Alex J. Tunney when I write stuff down, because I like the way it sounds better. I have a BA in English from the College of St. Rose up in Albany, and an MFA in creative writing from the New School, but most importantly, I'm a former STACie.
Hi, I'm Elise. I am in 11th grade.
That's totally fine.
Workshop I taught was about how poets use words, and not just to explain things, but as a way to design stuff in their own poems, in a way artists use words to communicate a message. If artists like Barbara Kruger and Jenny Holzer, how they use words in their artwork.
I was really influenced by the Jenny Holzer poem that was displayed on the side of a building, and it really influenced my writing because I had to put my writing on a ceiling, and I immediately thought back to that poem.
Would you be comfortable reading it?
Yes.
Okay, awesome, go ahead.
Depression is cool. You sit there looking at your ceiling. So many dust particles floating around the room. You watch one fall. So peaceful and tranquil. You try to move your hand to catch it, but then you remember you can't.
What I like about Elise's work is the subtlety. It takes an astute mind to realize, like, you don't have to go big or go crazy sometimes. Sometimes it's just like the right font and the right kind of background, and figure out how all the pieces go together.
When I was writing it, I had this idea. I saw this, someone wrote on the board, depression is cool, and that really hurt me, because I'm like, who would joke about something like that? But then I thought, I can make this into something beautiful. I saw this assignment, I started writing the poem. I was like, maybe I could put it on a bed. Well, where are you laying in the poem? I was like, on your bed. So where are you looking? The ceiling.
Figuring out where to place the text is mm-hmm. just as important as the message as well. And I think that shows in the piece. It all kind of gels together to create a striking image and a striking message.
Alex, thank you, everybody. I'll see you later. And Elise.
My name is Maria Gamboa, and I've been in STAC for almost a year, because I'm a freshman. Surprise! So we had a costume design workshop with Michelle Lee, and Michelle Lee is a former STAC student, and she does like professional costume design for a living. So we read The Resistible Rise of Arturo Uy for her workshop, and for the first deliverable we put together research boards, and research boards are basically kind of photos that you gather from the internet to help you actually design. The second one was more design based. Yeah, this one was more for the costumes and less research. I was the costume designer for this year's musical Edges, and something that I learned from Michelle's workshop that I like really helped me was that you should read the script like over and over. And actually for Edges, I spent like couple hours like just reading like the lyrics to the songs just over and over, and I actually put together research boards like what Michelle taught us. I was really excited to see like my work put on stage for like other people to see, because I've never like done that before, and yeah, I was proud of myself. There's a lot of work that goes into costume design, and it's not as simple as just this color looks good with this color. There has to like actually, there's a lot of thought behind it. So don't take costume designers for granted.
Hi, my name is Adhiri Kadilkar. I'm a junior and I have been in STAC for 1.5 years now. I was basically AD or assistant director for Edges, which is in this context, Gioia's bright like arm and leg.
Hi, I'm Maddie. I played Caitlin in Caitlin and Haley.
Hi, I'm Lily. I played the mom in Caitlin and Haley.
Hi, I'm Sonia. I played Haley in Caitlin and Haley.
I just basically got the chance to have a number of my own within the entire musical, which was really interesting for me, just because in my past experience and what I've witnessed, assistant directors really don't have much of like their own responsibility. They're kind of just there to help out. So it felt really nice to like, I guess, have something that's my own. I directed a number called Caitlin and Haley in Edges, which is about two sisters.
So Caitlin and Haley is about two sisters that have like the classic sibling relationship of I hate you, you grew up too soon, yada yada, like you're annoying.
I have an older sister, so I was able to like, you know, go from my past experiences in my relationship and funnel that into what we put up on stage.
Sibling relationships can be very much of a roller coaster. And fights, like little fights like these, they don't really matter in the long run. So you hate each other for 5 minutes, but then you love each other again.
Collaboration is always like a big part of the directing process because you have so many different minds put together and everyone brings something new to the table.
The mall was not part of the script originally. It was our assistant director, Aditri, who actually was the director of this song in particular. She chose to make the artistic decision to have the mom in the scene along with the two girls that are fighting.
So from my initial reaction of hearing the number for the first time and like watching videos on YouTube and you just see like these two people singing, I kind of personally felt like there was something missing. And I think it's just because like me and like Lily, Sonia, and Maddie, we're all siblings. So we all do have like a younger, older brother, sister. So when it comes to those like arguments and those situations, there's always like a third party involved. And I think we all kind of came to that group consensus and being like, we need like another person. And luckily I'm really glad that Lily was like ready to work with us in this number and like contribute and just be the missing piece of the puzzle.
Working with Aditri has been amazing because it's just so refreshing to have another student direct something, especially something that's so widely shown to the rest of the school.
And I was really lucky to work with three actors who I have worked with previously and who I do know and consider some of my, like, my friends. So it was really interesting to like, it didn't seem like a tedious job. It was like, oh, I'm putting together something cool with my friends. Like, let's talk about it and let's create something. I wish Caitlin moved back in. I wish Haley had tough skin. I wish I had my sister back. My stupid, ugly sister back. We'd stuff ourselves and get real back. Stay downstairs for a midnight snack. I hope we're on an upper track. All sides of our I'll make a pack. She'll make up all the parts I lack. If I could have my sister back.
O.P.
Stop. Stop what? Stop napping. Stop
noodles.
No. Stop now. Should I stop?
Blech.
Okay, I'm done. I'm not touching it anymore. I'm not even touching it. Why is it still going? Dude.
Hi, my name is Lily. I'm a senior right now and I've been in STAC for 4 years.
I'm Nicoletta Karras. I'm a sophomore.
When I was first asked to paint a mural, I was a sophomore, and I was so intimidated because I've never done anything like that before. But everyone in STAC was so encouraging and, you know, pushed me to do something out of my comfort zone, and I think that was the thing that gave me the most confidence and really, you know, helped me to create something that I'm so proud of.
My first thoughts when asked to paint this mural was panic. I panicked a little bit. Once I got started though, it was a little bit better, but it was also very intimidating because I had other murals around me painted by
other students in class, and that was almost like a, I started like comparing them, like what is my work compared to theirs. Something that helped me push past that while painting was being reminded that I have my own style and that it's not like everybody else's. And I kind of took that and ran with it. My first mural was super planned out because I was, you know, a sophomore and I didn't really have any experience. But my second mural, I decided to tackle it with absolutely no idea in mind. And I actually would say that I'm so much happier with the second one than I am with the first one because it's so spontaneous, but that's how I got the most interesting ideas.
The procedure for painting a mural is first you have to black out the wall or white it out. After that, I sketched it on a piece of paper just to get a general idea of what I wanted to paint. After that, I went to the wall and started chalking out the design. This was kind of, this was a little bit of a painful process because the proportions were way off, so I had to keep on redoing it. But I like the way it turned out, so I'm happy with it.
There was a lot of doubt in my mind about certain ideas, but then, you know, one of the things we live by in STAC is bold optimism and just go for it. So, you know, I pushed those doubts aside and I just went for it. And I'm really proud of what I created.
The murals are important for STAC because it shows what we can do on a much larger scale when it's permanent on the wall for however long you want it to be. I think it's much more of a, like a statement of what STAC can do.
For STAC in particular, I believe the murals are, you know, obviously a representation of the self-expression and the creativity we have in the room. They're also an expression for how we're not afraid to show what we're capable of. You know, I think one of the best part about the murals is that, you know, it changes almost every year. So, you know, I'm excited to see what unsuspecting student will be able to create something amazing on these walls.
And the world becomes a fantasy, and the world becomes a fantasy, and the world becomes a fantasy. You stumble through your days, got your head hung low, your sky's a shade of gray, like a zombie in a maze. You're asleep inside, but you can't shake away, cause you're just a dead man walking, thinking that's your only option, but you can flip the switch and run. Your darkest day. Sun is up and the colors blinding. Take the world and redefine it. Leave behind your narrow mind. You'll never be the same. Come alive, come alive. Go and light your light. Let it burn so bright. Reaching up to the sky. And it's open wide. You're electrified. When the world becomes a fantasy, and you're more than you could ever be, cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open. And you know you can't go back again to the world that you were living in, cause you're dreaming with your eyes wide open. So come alive.
Am I hot?
Ugh.
Let it burn so bright, reaching up.
Hey STAC, congratulations on an amazing STAC Night this year. I know that I said that I would not appear in STAC Night this year, that I would let you all run the show, but I lied. I couldn't bear to close out the year without thanking you all and congratulating you for all that you've accomplished. This year was pretty bananas. You know, our normally tightly knit ensemble was challenged by social distancing and hybrid learning, but this was one of the most productive years the program has ever seen. We accomplished just so much on our at-home days where we were working on remote assignments with our daily practices. We invited workshop leaders in remotely, where we got to work with artists and professionals from all across the country, like James III and Michelle Lee. Just STAC Night, the way that we did it, was not something I could have imagined a year ago. None of this happens by accident. You accomplished this. My job is, as the STAC teacher, is to lay the bricks before you, and you all walked the path. And this year, you all ran it at a clip I never could have anticipated. Some of you danced down it, some of you painted the bricks along the way. So I have one last lesson to impart upon you this year. You will face challenges and obstacles in your life as you continue to navigate from your teenage years into adulthood. Those challenges, they may present as roadblocks from the outside, but some of the most difficult challenges that you will face will come from inside. It's that voice inside you that says, I can't, or I'm not good enough. It's a voracious kind of voice. It kind of sits on your shoulder and craves validation. And I wish I could tell you that it goes away when you get older. It doesn't. It kind of quiets down a little bit. you know, you can look to this year as a powerful weapon against it. When you hear that voice tell you that you can't do something, you just look at this year and you see the power of your example and you say, I already have. When you hear that voice and it says that I'm not good enough, you say, well, look what I made under much more difficult circumstances. I know that I can do something like this again. Eventually you can get kind of harness the power of that voice and it becomes weaponized and you can use it to motivate and inspire you to create some of your best and brightest work. Of course, you can do all this, friends, because you already have this year. I want to thank Ms. Arnold and Ms. Zebrowski. I want to thank all of our workshop leaders for this year, and of course I want to thank you all, the STACies. For those of you who are graduating, know that the STAC door is always open to you, and I'm always on your side. And for the rest of you, I will see you in September. To close out our evening, here's a song from Allyson Greenwood's solo project. Have a great night, everybody.
Wish I looked like her instead of everyone thinking that my birth mother is gone. So I'm left with me, tainted colors aglow, and I'm still just a half-blood person that she will never know. I should be fine.